finally out the motherfucking CPT. Off to other cities and shit. No longer just an underground hit. Moving things. A local nigga made good and made a name off of making tapes for niggas in the hood. And now, let me tell a little story about the places that I've been to and the shit that I've been through. Like fighting in shootouts and banging and shit. All because a nigga made a hit. Check it. 1991, it was double or nothing that a nigga would hit. Then we broke out with the funky shit. I bought bitches and niggas and getting drunk and off that bud. I was doing the shit they hadn't heard of. But foolish was I to think that it wasn't no other cities like this. And they didn't like this. That Compton was the home of a foot in your ass. Well, you got blast, and now that's just a thing of the past. Let me tell you why firsthand. We did a show up in Oakland and niggas was kicking up sand. To them, banging ain't nothing new and slanging ain't nothing new. And for every nigga we done shot, they done shot too. Straight doing low since the 60s, before I was born. Families of young niggas more. So I'm just letting you know that if you plan to take a trip to the bay, keep your hand on your clip, because Oakland
is just like Compton.
Yeah, I'm telling y'all Oakland.
It's just like Compton.
Moving on to St. Louis, where the country is fucked with gold teeth in their mouth, but they still know what's up. Where it's hot as a motherfucker, hot enough to make you cuss. That's why I kept my ass on the bus. But later on, when it cooled off, we came down and met a couple of friends who put us up on the St. Louis cap, the Smith Center, with Big Bob, Little Steve, Toe Joe, Vince, and Rich, and a couple of bitches. Then they took us to a man named Gus in his store. He put me down with a herringbone and shoes galore. That's when I started thinking that this wasn't like home, but then they had to prove me wrong. Cause later that night, after we did the show, we went back to the after set. And wouldn't you know, yeah, Bloods and Crips start scrapping and shoot in Missouri. Damn, how could this happen? Now St. Louis.
It's just like Compton.
Yeah, y'all, St. Louis.
It's just like Compton, nigga.
I don't think they know. They too crazy for their own good. They need to stop watching that Colors and Boys in the Hood. Too busy claiming 60s, trying to be raw and never even seen the show. But now back to the story that I'm telling. We packed up the tour bus one more time and started bailing. When we arrived, I saw red and blue sweatsuits. When I'm thinking about horse dude and cowboy boots, I guess Texas ain't no different from the rest. And San Antonio was just waiting to put us to the test. And before it was over, the shit got deep. A nigga got shot in the face and was dead in the street. Then they came in the club thinking of scrapping. Little did they know that we was packing. Yeah, we was putting them down and scaring the rest. Shit, I even had to wear the bulletproof vest. Now San Antonio,
it's just like Compton.
Yeah, San Antonio,
it's just like Compton, bitch.
After about a month on the road, we came home, and I can safely say that LA is a much better place to stay. How could a bunch of niggas in a town like this have such a big influence on niggas so far away? But still my story ain't over, cause I got one more to tell. And the people of Colorado, they know it well. It was all in the news, and if you don't remember, I had the show I did in Denver with a punk ass promoter in a bunk ass skating ring. Bitches was loving it, but niggas was shoving the shit to the front of the stage to throw their gang signs. But I'm getting paid, so I didn't pay it no mind. Then I put out my brew onto their face and chest. Then they start throwing soda and fucking up my guests. When it was over, two niggas needed stitches. Got cracked in their jaw for being punk ass bitches. Now Denver.